Every by tag has a conversion factor attribute, and typically that conversion factor is ignored. It defaults to 1, so there really is no conversion. But that's a multiplier that's used to change the number from one unit of measure to another. So if you're going to be using the tagtote function in Pi, it is used specifically to correct the assumption that Pi makes that the data is always in units per day. Now, let me explain. If we take a look at this table, you can see that there's really a couple of things at work here. There's the engineering units of the rate tag as it actually exists. And that could be one of these units, units per day, units per hour, units per minute, or units per second. Now, let's compare that to the assumption that Pi makes when you try to do a totalization of any of these. Pi assumes, well, it always assumes the same thing, that the rate is in units per day. So you'll notice that Pi really does not understand or pay attention to the eng units field. We do not look at the engineering units and actually derive units. Instead, for all calculations that involve totals, we assume that the flows that we're totaling, or the units we're totaling, are in units per day. So when you do, in fact, have something that's measured in units per minute, you have to multiply that by the number of minutes in a day in order to get the actual result. I mean, just to give you an example, if I had an average flow of 24, okay, during a 24 or excuse me, an average flow of 50 during a 24-hour period. Well, you really have to ask yourself to figure out a totalization, is that 50 what? Is it 50 per day, 50 per hour, or 50 per minute? Well, if the average is 50, we assume that that's measured in units per day. If in fact that was you were making 50 widgets, not per day, but 50 widgets per minute, you would take that 50 and multiply by 1440. That would give you the number of widgets you've made in that day. So the only four conversion factors you'll ever need for the tagtote function are going to be these four conversion factors here, typically. I mean, sometimes we've seen customers who had, we actually saw a customer that had a measurement that was measured in units per half hour. So for units per half hour, they used a conversion factor of 48. Oh, and incidentally, it doesn't matter whether this is a 1 hour total or a 24 hour total or an 8 hour total, you're still going to use the same four conversion factors. Now, if you'd like to parse it out, you can take a look at an example of how we are making use of that conversion factor. So, for example, here's the calculation as we would say it. If it were a flow that were being measured in units per hour, we would take the result that we're getting and multiply that by 24. And of course, the reason we do that is because when we look at the units, we're assuming the units are always in units per day, but in fact it's units per hour, so we multiply by 24.